You clicked on the thumbnail. You know what we're building today. This is my favorite kind of video where I just take random useless junk that was given to me and try to build something useful or cool out of it. So we'll start with this hoverboard. It has a dead brain board. The main board is non-responsive, but from what I can tell, the motors and battery pack is fine. And here we have an old scooter that was given to me. It's originally a lead acid battery scooter with a brushed motor. So the performance is pretty crappy, but I think one of my kids took this off a sweet jump. I think maybe the magnets are broken in the motor. It's got some nasty bind up and click, and the chain would never stay tight because the shaft is bent. So anyways, we're gonna get rid of this whole back half and upgrade this thing to 18650 lithium battery pack, lithium ion battery pack from the hoverboard, which definitely increased the voltage too. Anyways, we're gonna get rid of this brushed DC motor for these two brushless motors. So performance will go up quite a bit. A lot more range, a lot more speed, a lot more power. And the only thing I had to buy is the speed controller. This is just a universal brushless scooter speed controller, 500 watt, 36 volts. It's a 36 volt battery pack in the hoverboard. And this came with the kit with the throttle. So it'll make the throttle and wiring and mounting hopefully straightforward. Even has a battery health indicator on it too. This was less than $20, so heck yeah. No, next step to do is just tear this stuff down and build it into a shape of a cooler scooter. This is what the scooter looks like with everything removed that I don't need. I think I'm gonna hang on to the seat mount for now. And here's the brushless hub motors. Leftover scooter parts, well, leftover hoverboard parts, leftover scooter parts, new speed controller, throttle. I'm probably gonna keep the foot rest and reuse that, and the charger and miscellaneous charge ports and battery plugs, which I cut off of the old hoverboard motherboard. And here's a hoverboard battery. So this is the parts I'm gonna be combining together to make something, and this will probably all end up in the trash. And there's the old lead acid battery. And yeah, the old junk motor with a bent shaft, brushed, yucky, baby little speed controller from the original scooter. And these inside of here is the old lead acid batteries, of which are garbage, and they usually are always garbage after about 2 years. This is what I came up with for an axle. It's just some scrap steel. It's a solid axle out of an old lawnmower. And the tabs here are the original mounting tabs from the hoverboard. I just welded them to the ends of the steel rod, and my plan is to attach the axle stem of the motor using those U-bolts. Here's just a dry run test fit to make sure it's pretty straight and true as far as I can get it. Close enough anyways. Now it's time to go ahead and burn that axle in. Got the perfect amount of rattle can drips. Give it that character. I took this bracket loop that used to be up here to go up and around the rear tire. Well, since this is flat now, I just moved this to the back to give it the extension it needs for the cooler. And digging through my scrap metal pile, I think I found something that fits pretty darn good to hold the cooler in place and give it a handle for lifting. Not my prettiest of welds, but this mount came together nicely. This will keep the cooler from falling back. These little tabs hold the sides of the cooler to lock it in. I have just a tiny bit of black paint left. I gotta stretch it and make it work. I'm right down to the bottom of the can. Come out. If I spin the nozzle a little bit, so when I tilt the can, it... Nope, that didn't work. Nope. Darn it, I think I'm out of paint. Just blowing air. Ah. This is not the kind of paint I had in mind, but it is the kind of paint I have on hand. So it's getting brushed on. It's Rust-Oleum, so it'll work good for metal. Put it on nice and thick and hopefully get a couple years out of it before it rusts up. Get them welds nice and painted. Lovely bird poop welds, but I'm going for function today, not beauty. The scooter is done and some time has passed. I did have to order some different speed controllers. I thought that if I didn't use the Hall Effect sensor feedback, position feedback sensor, that I could get by with wiring the motors together in parallel. But no, there's some weird resonance thing going on when you do that, so I ended up having to order two separate smaller speed controllers. And, well, I ordered a pair from an eBay seller. I ordered two at the same time of the same thing, and they shipped two different speed controllers. So then I ordered another matching pair of speed controllers, and again, they sent me two different speed controllers. They had different plugs, different wiring, so I ended up having to take the two orders, combine them together to get a matching pair of speed controllers. So some time has passed. It's been a while, but it's done and it works, and I've actually put a few miles on it. We'll take a look under the battery cover here. The footstep. As you can see, I don't really have a nice situation for the charge cable. That's just the original hoverboard charge cord, so I can just use a regular original hoverboard charger to charge it. But the nice thing is inside of here there's room for two hoverboard batteries, so I just have a Y cable that I run them in parallel, so it's still 36 volts but enough capacity to get me a few miles. And the throttle, actually let me turn this on, I'm still using the original hoverboard switch as a main power. As you can see, the battery indicator works pretty good. It's set up for 36 volts, so it actually tells me the battery condition, and you just give it a little twist and she goes. Let's go for a ride. Funny stares from the people over there. And a dog.
start going, you're going that direction.
Yeah, there's no steering.
Yeah, you're a pretty good pitcher.
I'm back from a little trip, charging it back up with the hoverboard charger. Let's take a look at that wheelie bar, because if you lean back while accelerating, it will pull a wheelie. There's a AAA sticker for roadside assistance. And I think that is it. This is a fun little project. I think this would be great to take to something like a car show or something where there's a lot of walking and you got to keep refreshments handy. That's it for today. Thank you for watching, and we'll see you next time.